Traditional cooking is a major problem, especially for the women. The biggest challenge is about the health, because they breathe with the smoke, which is unhealthy and lead them to have like sore throat, sore eye, coughing, or lung and heart disease. My name is Sophea, and my passion is to support the communities to improve the people's health and economies. Actually, I was born in poor family. Most of the time, the cooking is handled by the women. First of all, they have to chop up the tree and then making the fires, and that take long time to start it up and also to cook the food. My mother is just like any other woman. She's also bearing with the smokes.
Around 4.5 billion people around the world lack access to clean modern cooking. Cooking with wood has a huge impact on carbon emissions. It creates more emissions than the global airline industry. At the same time, it's also the leading cause of deforestation in many of the countries we work in. Back in 2015, the two founding NGOs, Engineers Without Borders and Live and Learn, won the Google Impact Challenge to take what was a prototype biodigester at that time and then turn it into a social enterprise where we could actually sell it as a life-changing product. So at that time, I was lucky enough to be involved in that, was able to pack up the family and head over to Cambodia to kick it off. I remember one day, about a year later, we had about 10 staff, and I walked into the office and there was all these people in green shirts doing things. And I was like, oh wow, like this is actually real. So a big part of what we first did was actually just going out and spending time in villages, spending time with people to understand what their needs were, how they could interact with the product. People definitely saw cooking with wood as a problem at multiple levels, both for themselves personally, also their local environment, and they could see it wasn't sustainable. And they were willing to do something about it. It was just having the right solution for their contexts. So a biodigester is like a large stomach, basically. It breaks down all the materials, be it cow manure, animal manure, green waste, etc. And then the bacteria in there break it down into biogas, which can be used for cooking, just like LPG, and then an organic fertilizer that can increase crop yield between 5 to 30%, depending on what you're putting it on.
Actually, biodigester is not a new technology, but ATIC design is a plug-and-play system, which you can install in 3 to 4 hours, which is very quick, and it also can bear in the challenging environment, including flooded area, which is very common in rural Cambodia.
So COVID has had one really big negative effect and one very big positive effect on the work that we do.
For example, previously we do the sale by like old school selling, door-to-door selling. Because the COVID, we cannot go out and meet people. However, we switch to the e-commerce sales.
So if you take Cambodia, there are now more smartphones than people in the country. And e-commerce has gone from something that was a very sort of niche urban option towards it being available to everyone, and everyone across the country starting to use it. There's been a lot of changes in where people are living. So I think there's a lot of people living in urban areas bringing back some of the habits into the rural areas, which is great.
People now in Cambodia, they're concerned more about the health. They used to live in the urban area where they're cooking with like good or clean or modern cooking solution. So when they move back with the biodigester, they still have that. Lately, I was so happy and was very proud with ATIC that they introduced a second product called the e-cook induction stove, which I can give it out to my mother. So now she have a cleaner cooking solution, which is more healthy for her, and I'm very happy with that.
Once you understand the impact that solving clean cooking will have on the people and planet, it's hard to focus on doing anything else.